Hey guys, I wanted to do this video on using the GT-10 of signs. What you just heard was me doing some backing track things, and I had a rhythm part, and then when I changed to the lead part, with one press of a button, I added gain to the overdrive, and I raised the level to the overdrive, and I added delay. Now I did that by using the assigns section in the GT-10. So let's take a look at how I did that. Okay, this is my pedal board. I've got the GT-10 here. I've got my amp channel switcher here. I've got an Ibanez tube screamer and a Boss EQ7. I use that as a clean boost. And here is my two external FS5U pedals. Now you see control 3 and control 4. So I have control 1, control 2, control 3, and control 4. Now the way I have my patches set up, control 1 is always chorus. I never change it. Control 2 is always delay on off. I never change it. So I added these extra two pedals to do different things, and that's what I'm using the assigns for. Okay, now to get into the assigns menu, you press the master pedal effects button here. And then you scroll up to where you see assigns and you hit enter. Now I have four assigns activated right here, okay? The first assign I have to control pedal 4. Now, how do you change that? You turn this knob. By default, when you turn on the assigns, it's always set to control 1. You turn the knob. If you have the external pedals, you turn it to control 3. And now I have effects 2 on off, but this could be changed to anything by turning this knob here. Okay? You can go comp off, comp on off, preamp on off, whatever. I have it set to effects 2, which I have a phaser. Now, the next assign, number 2, I have control pedal 3. Now I have the overdrive distortion drive. So here it is, the overdrive distortion drive. Before I pressed on the pedal, it set at 50. When I press it, it goes up to 80, okay? Now to see that happening, I'm gonna press the overdrive pedal. Now watch, when I press it, watch, the drive goes from 50 to 80. Okay, see that? Now, go back to the assigns. Next one, I have also control pedal 3 assigned to turn the delay on and off. See the delay right here? On, off. Okay, the next one, overdrive effect level. You see right here? If you scroll down, you can change these to anything you want. You can change it to the solo level, solo switch, bottom, drive, mid boost, whatever. So I have this one set to effect level. Before I press on the pedal, my effect level is at 51. When I press it and I get a boost out of it, I set it at 55. Now let's look at an example of that. Okay, here's the overdrive stomp. Now watch the effect level when I press on the control 3. See, it goes up to 55. So you see these parameters changing, the drive and the level. On, off, on, off. Okay. And that's the only four assigns I have right now. You can have up to 8 different assigns, and you can control all kinds of different things. This is really just scratching the surface. So experiment with it, okay? Don't forget though, after you make an assign to one of your pedals, you have to turn it on by pressing the master button, and that activates the assign. Okay, here's another example of another one of my patches. This is my Plexi Rhythm patch. Now I have 5 assigns for this one. Assign 1 is the drive, changes from 12 to 30 when I press control 3 pedal. Assign 2 is control 4 pedal, and it turns effects 2 on and off, which I believe is a phaser. Assign number 3, delay on off using control pedal 3. Assign number 4, I change the EQ. I change the low gain of the EQ, so when I engage the pedal, I want more beefy tone and also a boost. And that does that. And I also change the high gain setting so it's not so shrill when I give it more boost. So that's just another example of how I'm using the assigns. But you can use it for anything you want, so be creative. Now, I hope you guys enjoyed my little video here. Now this is just scratching the surface of what the GT-10 can do with the assigns. So, you know, be creative. You know, come up with something great. you guys later.